गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, आई होप दैट यू ऑल आर वेल एट होम एंड दिस इज़ अवर सेकेंड क्लास, सो वेलकम टू योर बिजनेस स्टडी क्लासेस. आई हैव ऑल्सो टेकन योर वन क्लास ऑफ बिजनेस स्टडी एंड अकाउंटेंसी. नाउ दिस इज़ द सेकेंड क्लास. आई होप वट एवर आई हैव टॉच यू इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो दैट इज़ अंडरस्टूड टू यू एंड एवरीथिंग इज़ क्लियर विद यू. स्टिल एनी डाउट इज़ देयर, नो प्रॉब्लम. वेरी सून वी विल स्टार्ट टेकिंग योर डाउट्स ऑल्सो. Now today I am starting the topic again which I have covered in the previous video. First I will revise the topic, then I will continue with the new things. So in the previous video I have done human activities. Human activities means the human are engaged in various types of activities and he is doing that activities so that he can satisfy himself. Now the purpose or the objective behind this human activity will decide that whether these activities are economic activity or non-economic activity. Basically there are two types of activity. First is economic and second is non-economic. Economic activities are those activities which are undertaken to earn money. Economic activities are those activities which are undertaken to earn money, whereas non-economic activities are those activities which are undertaken to get the satisfaction, which can be psychological, emotional. Okay, so here is a definition. Economic activity refers to those activities which are undertaken to earn a living. Okay, that I have told you in previous video also, these activities are undertaken so that we can earn money. For example, worker working in a factory, shopkeeper selling goods in his shop, doctor attending to patient in his clinic, etc. Economic activities are concerned with all those activities which are concerned with the production, exchange and consumption of goods and services which are not available free. There are some goods and services which are not available free. So human beings are concerned with the production, exchange and consumption of such goods. These activities are known as economic activities. This all topic we have covered. Like economic activity, they have sold teacher teaching at a school. Okay, but if the same teacher is teaching his son, then it will not be a economic activity because she is not teaching her son to earn the money. Okay, non-economic activities refer to those activities which are undertaken to satisfy social, psychological and emotional needs. For example, housewife cooking food for her family, a teacher teaching his own son, attending a social gathering, etc. In non-economic activities, there is no expectation of any kind of monetary reward. They are inspired by sentimental reasons and are performed out of love, sympathy, sentiments and patriotism, etc. Now, economic and non-economic activities we have done in the previous video. Now, again we are taking their difference so that it will bring more clarity to us. Now economic activities which are performed with the aim of earning money and non-economic activities which are performed without the aim of earning money. Now they have given one more example here, that if doctor is attending a patient at his clinic, he will charge fees from him, so he is performing this activity to earn his fees. So it is an economic activity. Okay, but if a doctor is treating his own son, then he is not treating to earn the fee, he is treating his son so that he get well. So that is not an economic activity. Understood? Now what are the difference, what are the point of differences between economic and non-economic? First is objective. Objective is very clear, to earn money and to get any sort of satisfaction. Money measurement, yes, economic activities we can measure in money because we are performing only for earning money, so we can measure in money that what is the outcome of this activity. But non-economic activity we are performing for our satisfaction, and that satisfaction we cannot measure, so outcome of these activities cannot be measured. Expectation, when you are performing these economic activities, the expectation of human is to earn the money, but here the expectation is to serve the society, or you want to get your mental peace. So these are the expectations when you are performing non-economic activities. Duration, economic activities we are performing on regular basis, and for a longer period of time, means the activities which we are performing for earning money, for earning our livelihood, we have to perform for a longer period of time, okay? Or you can say whole working life, that means the time duration is very long, okay? Like in the age of 18 to 20 we start earning, and up to age of 60 or beyond 60 we are earning, okay? And we will do these activities on regular basis, whereas non-economic activities are performed on irregular basis, okay? While in a once we are doing, okay, like on Diwali we are doing the charity, okay, once my birthday or any special day is there, so we are doing charities on that day, okay? So they are not done on regular basis, so they are doing, we are doing occasionally, and they are limited. Like we are saying that they are the regular dealings, we are doing these activities regularly, they are done on irregular basis, okay? So that is the basic difference. Now two more points are there. End result, the end result of these activities is production of goods and services. Generally for economic activities, for earning the money, we are either producing the goods or we are providing the services. Only two methods are there so that we can earn the money. One more thing is there also possible, production and services is their production. After that we can also say that exchange of these goods and services, because some people are engaged in trading also. The end result of these activities is mental satisfaction of person performing them. Here the end result is not any kind of outcome in terms of goods and services. Here the outcome is only satisfaction. Next is example is given, teacher teaching at school, doctor attending his patient, worker working in factory. Whereas in non-economic activity, teachers teaching his own son or doctors treating earthquake victims for free. Okay, sometimes they are doing the charity in the society that they are planning for the relief camps, where they are treating the patients without any cost. Okay, that is the example of non-economic activities. Now economic activities we have done. Now if I am performing any task for earning the money on regular basis, that can be of three types. First is business, second is profession, and third is employment. Business means when you are providing goods and services to earn the money. Okay, that means in business we are engaged in a regular dealing of goods and services. Either I can produce and sell, or either I will procure and sell. Okay, in profession, first I will acquire some sort of qualification. It can be professional qualification, educational qualification. Then I will acquire some skills through experience. Then I will get the chance to pursue the any kind of profession. Employment, I am working under a employer, and I will perform my work as per the contract between the employee and the employer. So these three activities are there through which we can earn our living or earn money: business, profession, and employment. I have told you the meaning. Now the definition of business is there. You will read the whole page. I am just reading the main definition. Business refers to those economic activities. Business is an economic activity because you are doing business for earning money, which are connected with production, purchase and sale of goods or supply of services with the aim, with the main object of earning profit. Okay, either you can produce and sell goods, or you can purchase goods and then sell them. It is not necessary that all the time you will produce. You can purchase and then sell. And not only goods, in business we can deal with services also. Okay, so supply of services is also included there. It's not like that you will write down the half definition. You don't write this word. Okay, when you are writing definition in business study, it should be complete. Three areas the definition is covering. First is production and sale of goods, second purchase and sale of goods, and third is supply of services. All these three things are covering under business, so you will write down all the three things. Example is given to you, farming, manufacturing, fishing, etc. Thus, business is sum total of all gainful human activities which aim to create, exchange and possess wealth in the form of physical output and useful services. Okay, either you will be engaged in producing the goods which are having the physical appearance, or you may deal in the services. That is the main objective. Now characteristics of business. An economic activity, because we are doing business to earn the profit. production or procurement of goods and services, we are dealing with goods and services. Either I will produce and procure them and then sell. Okay. Sale or exchange of goods and services, that is related to that only, that either I will produce and procure goods and after that I will sell so that I can earn my margin of profit. I will purchase at a lesser price and I will sold on a higher price if possible, and then I will earn the profit. Next is dealing in goods and services on regular basis, that purchase and sale. Okay, both points, purchase and sale. Regular basis I will purchasing, on regular basis I am selling, then only these kinds of dealings are known as business. That means business is done on regular basis. It's not like that in a month or in occasionally you are doing the transactions. I have given you one example that you are selling old car and earning the profit. Okay, you sold your one plot anywhere, then you are earning the money on that. No, okay, that should be done on regular basis. Now the next point is profit earning. All 4 points which we have read there, that we are procuring the goods, selling the goods, then we are dealing on regular basis, all these things are done so that I can earn the profit. So basic objective of business is profit earning. Next is uncertainty of return, because today you are investing in a business, then you will start producing or procuring the goods, after that sales will take place. So sales is something which is related to future. It is a future event and which is uncertain. That's why it is uncertainty. There is an uncertainty that whether you will earn the returns or not. Returns means income, okay? Income on your investment. So your income on investment is uncertain because that income you are going to realize in future, and future is uncertain. So you cannot predict that definitely you will earn the profit. Now the last characteristic is element of risk. As future returns are uncertain, that's why we are saying that there is an element of risk in the business. Risk is when we are saying that the changing environment is going to affect our profit, then we are saying that there is a situation of risk. Okay, now I am telling you, if you are hearing the news, okay, because of this pandemic situation we have closed so much industries, so because of this environmental change their profit is going to be affected. Yes or no? Because if industries are closed, then sales will not be there, and if sales are not there, then how they will earn the profit? Okay, that is the environmental change. Because of that their return is uncertain. Okay, and that only, that it is not that because just of environmental changes I am taking this pandemic situation. Any kind of environment change will be there. Sometimes political changes are there, that government announce any policy, like if you know that 2-3 years ago government has announced that the disposable plastic products are banned. In that situation, how many industries are working there which are producing the plastic disposable products? Okay, like you are using the disposable glasses, cups of plastic. So these industries, their profit are going to be affected. So that is political change, okay, because government has announced that policy. So many things are there. Sometimes technological changes are coming in the economy, because of that our business is going to be affected. For example, when CDs has been introduced in the market, then VCR has gone, then pen drives comes, then the CDs has gone. So that is the same. Because of the changing environment, our business is going to be affected, and these changes are bringing risk in our business. Understood? So this is all about business. In the next video, I will start with the profession. Till that point, take care of yourself, and I hope whatever I talked to today, you, that is understood to you. This chapter is basically the world around you, okay? Whatever you are seeing around you, that all the things are combined here, but we are seeing that things only and only from the viewpoint of the business. Understood? So if you are correlating this subject with your actual world, it will be helpful to you to understand this book. I hope that you are finding interesting your business study. Now thank you class, take care of yourself and keep on studying at home. Thank you class.